Let's do some advanced activity planning. The new school year will start soon and you do your activity planning. You want to shift the core teachers into the higher year. So let's move the teachers from year 9 into year 10. You only need to select the swap teachers option. Click on the cell you want to modify and select the new teacher. In the best case, you also already entered the teacher's qualified subjects, because the list will be much smaller then. Moving up the names won't hopefully take too long this way. The advantage of this variant is that all constraints will stay the same. If you need to shift all teachers into the higher year, it might be easier to remove the highest year and modify the names the lower years. Just move into the year dialog to do that. You will get a detailed list of all modified names. Please be careful with this variant, since constraints will change also the year, group and subgroup names. So some constraints might be unwanted now. Sometimes you need to add two teachers into a single activity, or you need to change the activity tags. In that case, you need to select the modify activity. You will get directly into the modify dialog if there is only a single activity. Otherwise, you need to choose the wanted activity first. Modifying the teachers and activity tags works as always. But let's have a look into the modify dialog once again. You can't modify the split value anymore. That is sadly not possible anymore, since new consecutive identity numbers for the sub-activities might be needed and creating them will be critical, especially if other constraints use the old numbers already. So there are only two variants if you want to change the split value: delete the activity and add a new one. This variant is a clean variant, it will remove constraints that use corresponding constraints. The other variant is that you need to add the highest value for split that you might need. For example, if you don't know if you need 3 hours or 4 hours per week, just add 4 hours the first time. You might wonder, since you still can't change the split value by that. The trick is that you can deselect the active checkbox. So you can disable a sub-activity. But how to modify the weight of the min days between activities constraints, or the consecutive checkbox? Sadly, it is impossible in this dialog. But you can do it in the time constraint dialogs. I will show it in another video. Maybe you have got 4 hours English per week, but one of that hours should be a team teaching hour with 2 teachers. You might just add a new activity, but there won't be a min day constraint added automatically. It will be some work to do that manually. So it is better to modify the sub-activities. Just select the sub-activity and modify it. Please be careful if you have got selected active, inactive or all activities if you work with this feature, since the tables will look different then. So far we only added activities with teachers and students. But you can also add activities without them. You can find those activities with the pseudo-activities button, since they might not be visible in the upper and or lower table of the activity planning interface. Maybe there is a teacher meeting for a special group of teachers. Add an activity with all needed teachers but without students. Maybe the students need to have lunch in the 5th, 6th or 7th period. Add an activity with the student names, skip the teacher names, split it in as many parts as you have got days per week and increase the weight up to 100%. Even an activity without students and teachers at all might be useful. For example, if activities need a second room. I will explain that in another video. You might wonder how to modify or delete those pseudo-activities, since you can see them only if you press the pseudo-activities button. You only need to get into a activities dialog and maybe you need to reset the filter. There are a lot of other checkboxes in this dialog. Just check and uncheck them and find out yourself what they are exactly doing. All checkboxes affect only the visual of this interface. The hide button will be useful if you have got a small screen, since the tables will have got more space if the buttons are hidden. Only the delete all button is critical in this dialog, since it will delete all activities if you confirm it. You can't undo that. So don't forget to save regularly your dataset if you have done changes. I recommend to just add a number and increase it always, so you can still return to previous versions. Happy timetabling!